Thanks, David. Well, cops say he shot and killed a man and then carjacked a delivery truck.
Now, a citywide manhunt is underway to find that murder suspect. 16 WAPT's Andrew Kinsey has been following the story all day. Andrew, who are they looking for tonight?
Stephanie, tonight Jackson police are on the lookout for this man. He's 32-year-old Charles Johnson. They believe he's accountable for shooting and killing 22-year-old Eugene Roberts before hijacking or carjacking a FedEx truck and a desperate plea to get away. Late Tuesday evening, Clinton police searched this abandoned FedEx van for clues in connection to a Jackson homicide.
We think that the suspects may have took the truck from the driver trying to flee the scene.
Jackson police think the crime spree started on Culberson and Jane Avenue at 2 p.m. when shots were fired.
Upon arrival, officers found one individual suffering from multiple gunshot wounds. He has since been pronounced dead at the scene.
Police say 32-year-old Charles Johnson shot 22-year-old Eugene Roberts while he was sitting in his car.
And she said, "Mama, go back. He got a gun. He got a gun."
Brenda Davison says she saw Johnson flying down the street in an SUV as he tried to get away, but not before he crashed into her daughter's car.
He put a gun up to her head, made her and her son get out the car. So she got the car. He was going to take her car, but as he hit it, it won't crank.
Davidson says that's when he stopped the driver of a FedEx van, forced him out, and took off. The FedEx driver wasn't hurt. His van was found hours later in Clinton on Dawson Street. But police say Johnson was gone. Once again, JPD says if you know where this man is, 32-year-old Charles Johnson, give Crime Stoppers a call tonight. 601-355-TIPS. Live in downtown Jackson at police headquarters, Andrew Kinsey, 16 WAPT News.
Andrew, what about a motive in this case?
Stephanie, right now, the police tell me that this is still early in their investigation and they still don't know why Johnson wanted Roberts dead.
All right, Andrew, thank you so much for that live report.